Coming up in this month's SIP Rep, I'll be sharing all the latest news and giving you all the inside information around Remembrance Weekend and everything that happened throughout November, as well as sharing what we'll be getting up to this month in December with the lead up to Christmas. There is so much to tell you all. You best go grab your coffee and your biscuit, sit back and then take a look because you don't want to miss this one. Hi everyone and welcome to this month's SIP Rep. Can you believe this is the last SIP Rep until 2024? That is crazy. I thought I'd start by taking a quick look back over November as it's been a month full of activity. Did you see us on the BBC Remembrance Sunday? Wow, how amazing were our children and young people. It can be such an emotional weekend, but to see them overcome their nerves and to walk side by side as a community in their black and yellow scarves and march past the cenotaph in the National Service of Remembrance in memory of their parent was just incredible. We were so proud of them. Every single one of them has experienced the death of a parent who served in our British Armed Forces, and being able to take part in the National Service of Remembrance meant a huge amount to all of them. And the fact that they could be there and share that experience with other bereaved children, young people who truly understand what they've been through, just had such a positive impact. And although it was an emotional weekend, so many of the families and children, young people actually had big smiles on their faces because it was so positive as well. Seeing so many people line the streets and pay their respects to their parent was incredibly valuable to our members, reminding them that, you know, people really do care and showing them that their loss has not been forgotten. So many of them said to me, I can't believe how many people are here in London to remember our heroes and to support us. Thank you so much to everyone who was there or everyone who supported Scottish throughout Remembrance and paid their respects to our fallen. It means so, so much to us all. This year, Scotties also worked with the BBC and the Royal British Legion to make sure that bereaved British Forces children and young people had a presence in the Festival of Remembrance. Five of our young people took part in the Walk of the Remembrance during the show, and 18-year-old Libby actually took to the stage and read a short message reminding people that young people today are still impacted by the death of a serviceman or woman. It was so, so powerful and I felt really proud of them. I actually spent 2 days with them backstage at the Royal Albert Hall, supporting them through the rehearsals and the performances, and my goodness, you know, they did themselves, their heroes, Scotties and our military community proud. I felt absolutely honoured to be in their company, and I was able to just offer a bit of guidance and support wherever I could. If you haven't seen our Remembrance 2023 video yet, then make sure you take a look at it, as it really captures the whole experience of that weekend. Throughout November, we welcomed some amazing volunteers to Scotties HQ. They come sporting their Santa hats and their Christmas spirit, and they helped to wrap this year's Christmas gifts, and they absolutely smashed it. Sending out over 640 gifts and cards is a massive task. It's a big operation, so having fabulous volunteers who come in and help us is absolutely priceless. A few mince pies and festive chocolates later, and all the cards were written, all the gifts were wrapped, and everything was packaged and ready for the postie. Amazing. Now, I can't tell you what the gifts were, as it's a surprise for our families, but I am sure we will be posting some pictures on our socials over the festive period, so please keep a lookout. The Scottish team have also been prepping for our big event, the Scotties Winter Festival, over the month of November, and this event takes place very, very soon.
We're seconds away from establishing visual contact.
So we are all very excited. I love seeing our members come together to have some well-deserved fun. The event is very much focused on helping to raise lots of smiles and offer a memorable experience for all our members, no matter what their age or capability. All the activities are designed to encourage well-being, confidence, communication and team building, but most of all to help to encourage friendships to form. We're expecting around 195 Scottie members to attend our winter festival, so we've been working really hard behind the scenes to make sure it will all run as smoothly as possible. With any events that Scotties do, we put a lot of time and thought into making sure that we're offering the very best service to our families, and this starts way before the event itself and actually continues after the event finishes. So we think about how we're advertising the events to our families, the communications and the tones that we're using, and any barriers that might mean a family can't attend. Then we create resources, videos, graphics, WhatsApp groups, drop-in sessions, and support families with the cost of travel and provide them accommodation as well, so that we can reduce as many barriers as possible. It's so important that the families attending feel safe and supported throughout the whole process, not just at the event. I cannot wait for you to all see the photos and videos. Make sure again that you keep your eyes on our social media sites over the next couple of weeks to see how the Winter Festival went. It's so, so important to give bereaved British Forces, children and young people, the opportunity to come together in a safe and supportive environment, to meet others with similar experiences so they realise that they're not the only ones feeling how they do and they're not alone, they've not been forgotten, but also so they can develop those friendships and can provide each other with that peer support as they grow. Now, I talk a lot in these SIT reps about all the exciting activities and services and important events that we offer our children and young people. But what you don't often hear me talk about is more the operational side of Scotties. And although sometimes it can sound a little boring.
Oh, I'm awake.
I actually think it's really important to share, as we simply cannot run a charity like Scotties without the foundations being set, our goals being aligned and having a strong team working away in the background. Recently, we've just had our 2024 strategy planning sessions where we looked ahead to make sure the whole team are clear, committed and focused on the goals of 2024. I think often people forget about all the other important aspects that are involved with running a charity, like setting goals and planning to continue to move the charity forward, to make sure that we're reaching more children and young people who don't yet know about the charity, but may need our support, as well as making sure that we're providing the right service for our children and young people. Every penny that comes in or out of Scotties has to be tracked. Reports have to be created and sent to funders to prove how we're spending their funding and the impact it's had. Creative content needs to be developed and shared with all our supporters to make sure you feel a part of this journey and you can see where your donations are being spent. Tools and resources have to be put in place to make sure the Scotties team can all do their jobs in a safe, secure and supportive environment. All this and so much more happens behind the scenes every single day at Scotties, so that as a charity we can make sure that our bereaved British Forces children and young people are all able to receive the very best emotional health and wellbeing support, outstanding development opportunities and the chance to smile again. This is our team's promise and we have all signed the pledge, and don't forget you can sign the pledge too if you haven't done so already. You can join us on our journey to making sure that every bereaved British Forces child and young person has the support they need throughout their childhood. Do it now, go to the website and sign the pledge. See you all very soon. Don't forget, if you did want to watch our highlights video from this year's Remembrance Weekend, just click here. It really gives you a fab idea and a bit of an insight into what the weekend was like for the families who attended.